Hello friends, and welcome to another tutorial on Geeks for Geeks. In this video, we are going to understand the program which finds the level which has the maximum number of nodes. First, let us take some examples. We will use the level order traversal technique for this. We know that in level order traversal of binary tree, at any time, our queue contains all elements of a particular level. So, we find level with maximum number of nodes. We assume that the root is at level 0. In the above example, level 2 has maximum number of nodes, which is 3. So, 2 will be the output. Now, let us see the algorithm which will assist us in finding the level with maximum number of nodes. Note that we are using a queue data structure. Also, we need a level variable to store the current level, a max variable to store the number of nodes at a particular level, and a level number variable to store the level having maximum nodes. Let us also have a sample tree to test our algorithm. First, we push the root node, which is 2, into the queue. Now, we enter the first while loop. We have another variable, node count, which will store the number of nodes in a level. Node count will store the number of elements in the queue. Since we have only one element, which is 2, node count will be equal to 1. Next, since node count is not 0, we omit the break statement in if. We check if node count is greater than max, then we update the level number to current level. As node count is 1, which is greater than max, max will now be equal to node count and level number will be equal to current level, which is 0. In the next step, we pop the complete current level from the queue. Since node count is greater than 0, we enter the second while loop. Also, we need a node variable to store the front element which will be popped. Node will point to the front element of the queue, which is 2. Next, we pop the front element from the queue. Hence, 2 will be popped. Now, we will push the left and the right child of node if they exist. The left child of 2 is 1 will be enqueued. Now, the right child of 2, which is 3, will be enqueued. In the next step, we decrement the value of node count by 1. So, node count will be now 0. Since node count is not greater than 0, we come out of the second while loop. Further, we increment level for the next level. Hence, variable level will now be equal to 1. Again, we continue with the first while loop. Node count will now be equal to 2 as the number of elements in queue is 2. Since node count is not 0, we omit the if statement and continue. Since node count, which is 2, greater than max, which is 1, we update level number to current level and max to node count. Hence, max will be now equal to 2 and level number will be equal to 1. Next, we pop the current level. Since node count is greater than 0, we enter the second while loop. As we enter the second while loop, we assign the front node of the queue, which is 1, to node. Hence, node will now point to 1. In the next step, we pop the front item from the queue. Hence, 1 will be popped. Now, we push the left and the right child of 1. First, 4, which is the left child of 1, will be enqueued. Next, the right child of 1, which is 6, will be enqueued. Now, we decrement node count by 1. Hence, node count will now be equal to 1. Since node count is still greater than 0, we loop the inner while loop again. Now, node will point to 3. Then, we pop 3 from the queue. Then, we enqueue the children of 3 into the queue. Since the left child of 3 is null, nothing is enqueued. Next, the right child of 3, which is 8, is enqueued. Again, node count decreases by 1. So, node count will be now equal to 0. Since node count is not greater than 0, we exit the inner while loop. Then, level is incremented by 1. We continue with the outer while loop. As node count, which is 3, greater than max, which is 2, we update max and level number. So now, max will be equal to 3 and level number will be equal to 2. Next, we pop the current level. Since node count is greater than 0, we enter the second while loop. Now, node will point to 4. Next, 4 will be popped. Since 4 does not have any child, nothing is enqueued. Next, node count will be decremented by 1. So, node count will now be equal to 2. Now, node will be equal to 6 and 6 will be popped. Since 6 has a left child which is 5, so 5 will be enqueued. Again, node count will be decreased by 1. So, node count will now be equal to 1. Now, node will point to 8 and 8 will be popped. Again, node count will be decreased by 1. So, node count will now be equal to 0. Since node count is not greater than 0, we exit the second while loop. Next, we increment the level. So, level will now be equal to 3. Node count will be equal to 1 as the number of elements in the queue is 1. Since node count is not greater than max, we omit the updation of level and continue. Now, we pop the current level. Since node count is greater than 0, we enter the inner while loop and assign 5 to node and pop it. Since 5 does not have any child, nothing is enqueued and node count decreases by 1. So, node count will now be equal to 0. As the node count is 0, we exit the inner while loop and level is incremented. Since the queue is empty, node count will be equal to 0. Now, if node count equal to 0 is satisfied, so we break and control will come out of the while loop. Level number, which is 2, will be returned. Let us have a look at the time complexity of the program. This code will run in big O of on complexity. Here, n are the number of nodes in our tree. With this, we come to an end of this tutorial. For any doubts or suggestions, please leave them in the comment section below. Thank you for watching.